coming today, our chief guest, our honorable guest, has arrived here to bless us to make this function successful. And we initiate this function with flower tribute by all to our great mother. That is Professor K. Srinivas, IMSc.
On behalf of our Pi Mathematics Association, good evening, one and all present here. Just few words about our association. Our association initiated as a not profitable trust on 18th June 2007. Our association main motto is to get rid of the math phobia among the students. On behalf of our association, we published 12 books so far, and we conducted workshops also. For the past 3 years, we conducted internship program among college students in various colleges. Our association members giving lectures in various schools and colleges with the guidance of our founder. From this year, we decided to add a lecture series as an event of our association. In this, we start this lecture series on this special day because today is World Pi Day. On this occasion, our association is very much happy to welcome Professor Amritanshu Prasad from IMSc. He is the speaker of today's occasion. And I would like to welcome Professor K. Srinivas, sir. He is a very much close to our association from the beginning. He is one of the key person for upliftment of our association. So again, once again, I welcome you all. Enjoy this occasion. Thank you.
Now, Professor K. Srinivas, IMSc, will shower a few words on us.
Yes. So good evening, everyone. So it's a great occasion for me to be here again. So this, my association is pretty old with Pi Mathematics Association. Whenever we have some visitors coming to our institute, we take this opportunity to introduce to the general, interested students and teachers. So it's an interaction that we have been trying to build, and it has been very successful. There are lots of videos of lectures that have been uploaded by eminent personalities like Professor Raghunathan, Professor Waldschmidt, and many, many others. All right. And as you have seen, this association is not supported by any government agency. It is by well-wishers and few interested people who want to bring some change in society, in particular for the development or upliftment of general mathematical, culture. And it has been fairly successful, and the fruits are now, coming up. Like the efforts of association is now being recognized by many, many agencies. For example, the founder has got just recently the best teacher award by the Department of Science and Technology. It's a very, very interesting and encouraging thing for us. All right. So, and you know, the responsibility is, you know, with all of us, you know, to see to it that the association runs smoothly, and it is, and its motto is percolated to many, many corners of the society. And one more award you have just 2 days back, you have sent me. What was that?
That's Abdul Kalam Global Teachers.
Abdul Kalam Global Teacher Award also, so recently. So these are very, you know, small things, you know, many, many. So big thing is the recognition by the society, you know, by the teachers. The association people are being invited by many schools and colleges to give lectures. That is the biggest award and reward. All right, that's it. So today we have with us Professor Amritanshu Prasad, my colleague from Institute of Mathematical Sciences. So he is one of the youngest senior professor, okay, I would say, and who has done lot of work, not only in research, but in many, many areas. Okay, so let me briefly say his main specialization is representation theory, combinatorics, harmonic analysis, number theory and group theory. These are the research topics that he is interested in. He did his basic education BSTAT from ISI Kolkata, and then MSc from University of Chicago, and also he did his PhD from University of Chicago. There are many, many awards on his name, I mean, which has given to him. Like one of the most prestigious award is Swarna Jayanti Fellowship. Okay, this is given by the Department of Science and Technology. And he also got Young Scientist Medal by Indian National Science Academy in 2010. And also he is an associate member of the Indian Academy of Sciences. So these are very few that I am counting. And he has a very good book written on representation theory. It gives a combinatorial, you know, viewpoint of what is representation theory. It's a subject in mathematics. And there are several papers, I won't list them. And he has so far produced 3 or 4 PhD students and several MSc students. See, our research is, our institute has is only for PhDs, Institute of Mathematical Sciences. And so their students join to do their PhDs. Basically, our job is to do research, okay? And one of the interesting things that he is doing currently, he has been contributing quite a lot, is the mathematical program of computing called SAGE Mathematical Software. He's been able to, you know, also contribute to that. He's running some courses. He has been running and continuously is doing so. So today he will be talking to us on some very interesting topic called Platonic Solids. It's a subject of interest from ancient times. So, and he's very good in origami and things like that. Okay, to popularize mathematics. So we will have an interesting time. So let's welcome him to begin his talk.
Great pleasure to be here. Please have a seat, come. So we are all here because we love mathematics. So let's start talking about mathematics. So I'm going to talk about what are called Platonic solids. As Srini said, this is a topic of very ancient interest. It's an old thing, it's not something new. So, I suppose some of you here are college students and some of you are teachers, right? So, so does everyone here know what is a Platonic solid? Okay, so that's fine, I don't expect you to know that. But maybe you all know what a regular polygon is. Yeah? What's a regular polygon?
Oops, that's the teacup, okay.
So
it's an interactive session, so please open your
all the sides equal? Anything else?
Angles are also equal.
All angles are also equal, yeah. So all sides should be equal and all angles should be equal. For a triangle, if all the sides are equal, then all the angles will be equal. But for a quadrilateral, you can have a rhombus, like something like you can have something like this, right? I can probably draw this. Yeah. Well, the way I've drawn it, but it's not a regular quadrilateral. It's not a square. So it's a parallelogram with all sides equal. But let's not worry too much about it. So let's say a regular polygon is a polygon with all sides equal and all angles equal. So that was a, so that would be, so with three sides you have a triangle, with four sides you have a square, and let me show you a small trick to make a pentagon. You just take a strip of paper and you tie a knot, and then you carefully flatten it out. So you carefully flatten it out, and you'll see that there'll be one strip of paper coming out here, one strip. You just fold those away. Okay, so what is this? So that's actually a perfect regular pentagon. So this thing has all five sides equal and all these angles are equal. Okay, so you can have a regular pentagon, and maybe you can think about how to construct a regular hexagon. Yeah. So six sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And for every, then you can have a heptagon, octagon, and so on. You have, for every number n, you have a regular n-gon. Okay, so exactly one. So what we are going to discuss today is whether something like this happens in higher dimensions or not, okay, in three dimensions. So we want to talk about something that is like a regular polygon, but in three dimensions. So what is, so three-dimensional shape, right? So this this duster, for example, you may think of it as a three-dimensional shape, but its sides are not flat. So let's just think about three-dimensional shapes where all the sides are flat. So for example, a cube is a three-dimensional shape where all sides are flat. Such a shape is called a polyhedron. Okay, so in polygon is two-dimensional, higher dimensional we say polyhedron, just a name, nothing else. Okay, so this is a shape with all straight sides. Yeah, polygon is all, it's a two-dimensional shape, all the sides are straight lines. So we'll be looking at a three-dimensional shape, all the sides are going to be flat. Okay, so they are planes. It's a region that is bounded by planes. And we can also assume that it's convex. Convex means this is an example of a two-dimensional shape that is not convex. Why? This part here, so this is a quadrilateral. It has four sides. 1, 2, I don't know if you can see this. Actually, yeah. So this is not convex, right? Why is it not convex? So convex just means that if you take two points inside your shape and join them with a line, then that entire line should be inside the shape. So here I can find two points, for example this point and this point. If I join them by a line, that line goes outside the shape. So this is not convex. So we'll talk about convex polyhedron. These things, these regular things are all convex. See, you can do something funny here. You can draw a hexagon like this. Okay, these angles are not the same, but all the sides are still the same, but it's not convex. Okay, let's not worry about that too much. In three dimensions, it's a little harder to talk about angles. So we want to talk about a convex polyhedron and something analogous to regular, and that is called platonic. So Plato was a Greek philosopher. and mathematician. So he used to organize meetings of people who like to talk about philosophy and mathematics. And then they used to also have music, food and drinks, and they used to enjoy. Okay, this is maybe how many years ago? 2,500 years ago. And people have written down accounts of the... Plato himself wrote down these accounts of these meetings, and some of these discussions are very, very interesting, mathematically also very sophisticated, and there's also a lot of philosophy in it. So they were aware of that when you look at this three-dimensional thing, they thought about this question, and they were very much aware of the answer as well, so which I will tell you. So so I want to talk about a platonic solid or a platonic convex polyhedron. So you can also call this a platonic solid. So now what is it that we would like? We want it to be some very regular shape. So we can say that maybe all the sides, so it would have sides, right? Let me show you an example of some three-dimensional shape. Simplest one that you've all seen is a cube, right? So this cube, it has 12 edges like this, right? And what can we see in this cube? They are all equal length. So maybe we should at least require that all the edges be equal length. But maybe something more. You look at the faces of the cube. Each one is? It's a square. I'm sorry, in this model that I've made, there are triangles, but just regard this entire four triangles as one face. So this is a square. So in some sense, each face is a regular polygon. Okay? And all the faces are the same. So this face, there are six faces, all are the same. So what we are going to say is that all the faces should be regular polygons, and they should be the same regular polygon. Okay? And one more property that we can that we usually require is that basically each corner looks the same as every other corner. See, here we said that the angles are the same. So what we'll say here is that if you look at any corner, there are three faces coming to that corner. That number should be the same. So the same number of faces should be joined at each corner. Okay, so this is some way of trying to say that we want a very regular pattern.